Better University. My name is Steve Caliper. We're certainly excited that you've joined in and now you're a part of this journey. And, you know, 2018, as I've mentioned, as we kind of kicked off with some communications last week, I think 2018 is going to be a phenomenal year. There's a lot of things to be encouraged and excited about. First is to take a step back, and we're going to game plan a little bit as it relates to setting goals and looking at your schedule essentially for the year. And we're going to lay out some of those tools, and we're going to give you a great offering to help you frame that. But let's take one step back and just take a look at, you know, what's happening in the lives of donors. You know, coming into the new year, there's a lot to be excited and encouraged by. Economy's up, bonuses are being paid out, cash flow seems to be pretty strong in our economy, and people overall are feeling pretty good. And then when you look at what's happening in the area of Christian donors, you know, a lot of excitement around making a difference in the lives of people, sharing the message of hope, which we certainly know and recognize as a relationship with Christ. And people are thinking big picture. They're thinking big picture to what's happening around the world. And donors in particular are looking at how can they be a very strategic and a valued partner with ministries and organizations like yourself. So, as I mentioned, 2018 is going to be a great year. As you've also heard me share, I think it's very important that that all of us look at the difference between being relational and friendly. Many of you have heard me share this before, and I think it's important that we're friendly, jovial, and we're caring people in the area of whether it be we're leading our organization or we're on the front lines in the role of and development donor relations. But being friendly isn't the art of it. You know, the art of it is really being relational. Being relational is two-sided. Friendly is being one-sided, but relational is two-sided. Being able to pursue and get to know and to hear one's heart by asking the right questions, getting to know them, making sure there's alignment, because it's not a transaction. It's a journey that we're in with people. We're in a journey with people relationally. And, you know, we can get away with it for a season being friendly, but I want just to make sure that we're emphasizing the relational part as it stands to pursuing, getting to know someone, and again, asking questions and listening. And here's really kind of a great train of thought, as it were to be. You know, being friendly and knowing about people is one thing, which is, you know, are they married? How many kids do they have? Where do they work? Things about them. But when you're really pursuing and getting to know someone relationally, you know their heart, you know what their triggers are, you know what gets them excited, because that's really the art of building out a relationship campaign. And the art of donor development and the art of building a relationship campaign is really knowing the individual's heart. Now, you can do that individually or groupings or certainly within your portfolio. So let me kind of speak to the portfolio piece to transition to what we would define as both quantitative results and outcomes from 2016 and 17 to the qualitative, because they really go hand in hand. So it's quantitative and qualitative. The quantitative is taking a snapshot of the data, whether it be as an organization, you know, looking at your database or your individual portfolio, if you're a rep with an organization. And what I'm meaning there is, however you're defining your donor segments, a lot of groups would define a regular donor as a donor that gives up to $1,000 to $999. A lot of organizations might define a mid-tier donor as someone that gives $1,000 up to $4,999, and a major donor is $5,000 plus. Or your ranges could be slightly different, but I think you get the idea. It could be $1,000 to $2,500, and then $2,500 to $10,000 as mid-tier, and greater than $10,000 as a major donor, for example. The mega donor, mostly categorized as one that gives greater than, say, $25,000 in some cases. And even in some organizations, if you have a lot of major donors, you're looking at mega donors being someone that gives $50,000 or even $100,000. And I think that's important to distinguish that. But take a look and break that down by segment. And that's just the quantity, looking at the number of people that supported your organization or who are in your portfolio that give it that certain breakdown. I think it's also important to note and to recognize, you know, how many people gave in 15 or 16, but maybe didn't give in 2017. Let's not forget that there were some folks that didn't give, and that's okay. There's a lot of things that happen in a person's life or in a family's life that keeps them from supporting, but identify who are, quote, your lapse group. And then if you're one that manages relationships with, whether it be church groups or foundations, you know, note that also. So that's important. Then the qualitative side is looking at the messaging. How did you communicate with donors in various segments, whether it be a major donor, mega donor, or regular, or as an organization, how did you reach out to and to connect with them as a group or as segments based on the qualitative, which was e-communications, mail appeal, thank you calls, meetings. How did your developing a relationship and rapport, whether it be through written form or through oral form when you were meeting with folks or either in a group setting, how did the message of what it is that you're doing and why you're doing it resonate with them? Looking at the quality around, you know, too much frequency, you know, were there too many e-communications where it didn't resonate? Because you can deplete the value and the response rates if you're just, you know, too much. Mail appeal, finding the right balance. So it's important that you assess the data, look at what you have to work with from, call it end of year 2017 in various segments, including lapse. Don't be afraid to take a look at your lapse donors. And then look at the qualitative, you know, really assess and evaluate what worked, what didn't work, too much frequency, e-communications, mail appeal. If you hosted donor calls or webinars, look at the frequency around that. And then what was messaged? You know, so getting a sense of both qualitative and quantitative. Now, when you get your head and your heart around the data, it's just honest data. There's no other way around it. It's just the data is what it is. Whether you're over your goals or short or whatever it is that happened between that at your end, but take a look at that data. Now, you're able to sit back and, you know, it's January 2018. So let's project ourselves forward to January of 2019. As you've heard us as a team share, provision follows vision. And so when you look at where do you want to be as an organization from a program standpoint, from an output or ministry, from key strategic initiatives, whether it be in a local community or somewhere around the world, whether it be in Southern California or Atlanta or maybe in Kenya, wherever it is that you're doing your ministry or doing your program, take a look at what do you want to accomplish as a ministry team in January of 2019. Now backfill it with what is it going to take to achieve the result of your ministry from a dollar standpoint. And you know what your budget is, but then looking at the data, really honestly look at the number of people that are giving as a major donor, regular donor, a mega donor, number of foundations, church partners, and assess. You know, how many people do you need to give in that, whether it be a pyramid chart or just a numeric? And so if you need to up your major donors by a certain percent, say you need to grow up by 20% or 50%, or you need to reactivate lapsed donors from, you know, 10% reactivation, you know, take a look at that and set some goals. Now, once you've done that from a quantitative standpoint and qualitative standpoint with messaging, and you get a look, you get a snapshot of your data. Look ahead. What is it that you're trying to accomplish this calendar year from a ministry initiative standpoint? And then just backfill with what is the financial support you need to achieve that? And then look at how many donors that you're needing per segment to make that a reality. Now, when you do that, you sit back, you can invite your board members, advisory team. You can even invite some donors of yours who are not just supporting you financially, but see themselves as a part of the mission. And I believe that you can invite some people into that. Now that dictates really your activity. Many of you have either read it in my book or you've heard me share it, that positive activity creates opportunity. And so now you can manage and focus in on what is the right activity that you want to outline per quarter and then for the course of the year. And invite people into helping you achieve within the activity of what you're trying to accomplish. Invite people into helping you achieve your goals. Now, we look at the calendar year from a development tactical plan standpoint. We break that into five seasons. And this is going to be our offering to you. is looking at the development schedule for the course of 2018, broken into five seasons. So we have winter, spring, summer, fall, and year end. So the five season. Now, the qualitative is what is the theme and the messaging of what you're wanting to communicate per each of those five seasons. The second part of the development schedule is what we call the relationship campaign. So we want to make sure that you're looking at each of those five seasons based on goals and objectives, as well as your activity. And the activity is number of thank you calls, personal visits, how are you following up with and connecting with people that didn't make a gift in 2017 that would be your lapsed donor. Let's not forget that, you know, thinking active major donors or regular donors is important, or mid-tier. But let's not also forget the follow-up and to making sure that you're communicating and connecting with people that lapsed. Maybe there was a life event. Maybe there was a death in the family. Maybe there was a downturn in the business. I can't tell you countless illustrations where somebody rebounded in their business, or they had a life event that took place and they came back and became a significant contributor to an organization when the ministry of the organization didn't forget about the relationship that they had with that person when they weren't in a position to give. But when they rebound and they come back, they usually are pretty touched by the fact that you stayed with them and that you pursued them and wanted to continue to stay in the journey with them. And they didn't feel like they were just an ATM machine or a checkbook, but that you really cared for them. So make sure that you're doing that. So then when you look at the activity through the year, you know, what are the right things that you're wanting to do through the course of, call it 2018, per season? Whether it be goals for each of the five seasons, take a look at how you're assessing data, your dashboard, and, you know, be intentional. Reactivate, you know, 10%. Make sure that you're connecting with 10 donors or a percentage of the donors. Looking at, you know, what are the right luncheons and gatherings? Can your board participate or advisory team on just making thank you calls? Does your ministry or organization have vision trips that you're wanting to make sure that you're inviting people into, whether it be going to Kenya, or if you're a local organization doing inner city work in Santa Ana or in Houston, invite people as a half day or quarter day trip into seeing what it is that you're doing. You know, a vision mission trip doesn't have to be to Africa or to Asia. It can be also just bringing them into what it is that you're doing locally. So there's a lot of things to be taken a look at, but for 2018, assess the data, look at it from a quantitative as well as a qualitative objective and outcome. So then you can assess where you're at. Take a look at your goals. You know, where do you want to be from program, key initiatives? What's the provision that needs to fund your vision and your mission? And then backfill with what are the segments of your donor file in your database that you need to make sure you're being intentional to grow, to add, an increase both from lapse perspective. And let me touch on the add piece. You know, just frankly, adding a number of new people to your donor base is really important. It might be that you sit back and you say, with the sharpening of the message, we're going to create the right environments. And our goal as a team is we want to add 100 people to the donor file. Or if you're a larger organization, it might be that you say, we want to add 500 people to the donor file. Whatever it happens to be, have the goals of what you're wanting to accomplish in mind. Now, on a quarterly basis, I would assess with your team, or yourself, evaluate what's working, what's not working. If it's having a difficult time connecting with mid-tier major donors, think about your approach. When you're looking at your development and your tactical plan, you know, don't overthink it, keep it simple. Frankly, I get asked this question a lot, you know, when's the right time to connect with folks and to think of, well, when you've earned the right. And so reaching out, making calls, texting them, whatever the format is that it takes for you to get some time with them. And let me kind of frame it this way, or encourage you. Don't always look for the meal. Certainly having a meal, breaking bread, praying with someone and being with someone over a meal is great. But sometimes it's as simple as grabbing a cup of coffee, going to their office, and whatever your intention is in getting to know them. So for today, and really what I wanted to encourage and share with each of you that are listening in on this is assess where you're at, Look at a snapshot to your data from 2017, qualitative and quantitative. Have your goals in mind for where you want to be in January of 2019, and be, you know, intentional and focused on where you're spending time. Be very focused on various segments and role they perceives and get at it. I believe that 2018 is going to be a great year. If we can be of any assistance to you between now and the next teaching sessions, just reach out, let us know. But thank you so much on behalf of my team, Development Services Group. Thank you so much. And on behalf of the journey of Doing Good Better at University, we appreciate that you've taken some time to be with us today. So thank you so much. Again, Happy New Year. 2018 is going to be a great year. Thanks so much.